Isaiah chapter 20, 21. And the Lord said to Joshua,
say to the people of Israel, appoint the cities, every group, tribute, officials of the Lord and Moses.
That the man's prayer will strike the person without him. We shall pray to one. We shall pray to one of these cities and shall stand at the entrance of the gate of the city and explain his case to the elders of the city. Then they shall take him into the city and give him a place, and he shall remain with them.
And if they are in terror of blood, they shall not give up the man's slayer into his hand, because he distrusts his neighbor unknowingly and did not hit him even in the past.
Then he shall remain in that city until he has stood before the congregation for judgment, until the death of him who is high priest at the time. Then the man's slayer may return to his own town, in his own home, to the town from which he fled.
So they set apart Kedesh in Galilee, in the hill country of Naphtali, and Shechem in the hill country of the Ephraim, and Kiriath Arba, that is Hebron, in the hill country of Judah.
Chapter 20 is telling about cities accusing. Before we learn about this city of accusing in Numbers and even Exodus, we learn about these cities of accusing. And but this city of refuge also connects city for divine. Because this cities of refuge, six cities from the city of Levi. Do you remember Levi people? They have no inheritance. But they get 48 cities from other tribes. And the city of refugee taken from city of Levi. That's why this 2021 is connected to each other. And we know that this city of refuge, why God allowed this city of refuge? Actually, in this 80s, the people, when somebody killed their family, they should kill mother. That's the etiquette manner or roast one. So if somebody killed my brother or my mother, me, my family, left to family, they should take revenge to his mother. But what about this? If I kill this mother, his mother's family also kill my family, and my family kill this family again. You know, this is like a breaking society. That's why God protects his avenged and society and nation. So that's why God allowed some man slayer without intention. They can hide in this city, but somebody can, oh, God allowed the mother, they can escape to the city. You know, the manslaying mother is the sin. We must separate. God protect society if God allow avenging to family, family to family. This will be breaking, destroying nation or city. That's why God does not allow destroying the city or nation. But murder is the sin. Murder is the sin. If we read Hebrew word, murder includes intentional or unintentional, include all both. Not only intentional murder. In the Hebrew word, this murder include unintentional slaughter. Even Ten Commandments, we know that do not murder. This murder was the same Hebrew word, including intentional, unintentional killing. So God, he do not allow murder, but he allow protecting city, nations. So anyway, this manslayer, without intention, they can escape to this city. Then they can stay there until high priest died. Verse 6. And he shall remain in that city until he has stood before the congregation for judgment, until the death of him who is high priest at the time. Then the slayer may return to his own town and his own home, to the town from which he fled. This manslayer, he can stay there until high priest died. We have a question, why? Why until high priest died? What is the job of high priest? He offering sacrifice for sinners. Right? High priest represents offering sacrifice for the sinners. Actually, once a year, he brings sacrifice for all congregation's sin, including his sin. So, this is like a symbol. If we stay, if the sinner stay in the city, his sin living by high priest. And high priest also the shadow of Jesus Christ. Because of Jesus Christ, our perfect high priest, our sin is atoned, redeemed. Actually, high priest Jesus died. High priest died, then he become free. Then, high priest, perfect high priest died. When Jesus died on the cross, our sin also taken away, and we become free because of high priest Jesus' death. So this high priest is the shadow of Jesus Christ, perfect high priest. That's the Hebrews in the New Testament. Hebrews explain Jesus is the perfect high priest. So, chapter 20 explains the city of the Jews. Then, chapter 21 tells us the city of Levi. Actually, Levi, they had no inheritance because God himself is the inheritance for Levi. But if we see the verse 1 to 3, the leader of Levi, then the head of father's house of the Levites came to Eleazar the priest of Joshua, the son of Nun, to the head of the father's houses of the tribe of people of Israel. You know, leader of Levi, they came to the leader of people of Israel. And they asked, verse 2, verse 3. And they said to them, at Shiloh in the land of Canaan, the Lord commanded through Moses that we be given cities to dwell in, along with their land for our lifestyle. So by command of the Lord, the people of Israel gave to the Levites the following cities and land out of their inheritance. Actually, God already commanded Israel they must provide city for Levites. Numbers 35, verse 1 to 8. So God spoke to Moses about the city of Levi. At the Moab, God spoke to Moses. And verse 2, command the people of Israel give to the Levites some of the inheritance of their possession as cities for them to dwell in. And you shall give to the Levites Hashoven around the city. God already talked to Israel through the Moses. They must provide city and Hashoven for Levites. How many? Verse 7 says, all the cities that you give to the Levites shall be 48 with their Hashoven. So 48 cities. And actually 6 refugees from these Levites, the cities. So verse 4, verse 4 to 42. Explain. Each tribe may provide city for Levites. Then 43 to 45 is the conclusion. This is the fulfillment of God's promise for the city.